Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Todoist series. My name is Carl Pullein and this week it's all about Todoist on your iPad. Now, since earlier this year, Apple have been really making the iPad into a little gem of a productivity tool. And they've been making it easier and easier for app developers to create some amazing drag and drop features that just make our productivity lives so much easier. And that's what I want to show you in this week's episode. I don't often do many videos on iPad and Todoist, but this week I'm going to show you some of my favorite tips and tricks on getting the most out of Todoist on your iPad. Now, before I go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my Todoist now on my iPad, and I'll show you just some of my favorite tips and tricks that you can use with iPad and Todoist. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how you can get the most out of using Todoist on your iPad. And iPad has really focused in on being able to drag and drop and move things around and share things. They've come up with some really great features for this. So let's just open up my Safari. And I don't know if any of you guys are aware, but the Range Rover this year is 50 years old. So let's just say that I'm going along and I think, wow, I really, really love this image. What I can do is I can now grab this image and I can just move it into my Todoist right here. Now, the beauty of it is now I've got a link, at least a link, to this particular image. In fact, I've got more than a link. I've actually got the image which has now come into my Todoist. And as you can see, that was really, really very, very quick. And that's the first thing that you can do. Now, what I should do is point out that when you've got your Safari open like that, if you haven't already got Todoist set up, and I've had this set up for such a long time, you can just drag up Todoist. And what you want to do is you want to release it at that point. Because when you release it at that point, now you have this floating box. It floats around. You can move it around like this. And that's what you really want. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to move this off to the side like that to show you the next feature. The next feature I want to show you is when I bring in email. So let's just say, oh, I need to reply to Autumn, who's sent me this hello message in my YouTube. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag this out. I can now grab that and I can just move that into my inbox like that. And now I have that email, which is going to remind me that I need to reply to that email. So that's just one or two things that you may want to do. Let's go back to Safari now. And I want to go back to the original search. So I just go back here. And go back to there, and they're going to go to all. So the Range Rover now is, as I mentioned before, is now 50 years old this year, and there's this wonderful article. Let's say, oh, I want to read this article. So I'm going to grab it from here. I'm just going to drag that down there, and I'm going to add there, and sure enough, it adds the link directly to my inbox. And those are really, really cool. But there is something else that you can do. Moving up, let's go into my calendar now. And let's just say that I want to do some things in my calendar. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to move to the side here. And let's just say that my I want to drag that in there. That's going to remind me now that I have a task that I can set up right in there, which will allow me to actually put my events into Todoist. Now, I wouldn't personally do that, but for those of you who want to be alerted to an event, then you've got that option right there inside your Evernote. Your Todoist. So there you go. So those are a couple of things that you can do with the iPad and Todoist. And as I say, that's brought out some amazing ways that you can quickly do that. And I'm finding myself increasingly using Todoist on my iPad to be able to get straight to my tasks. And one of the ways I've done that is I've got this shortcut from Todoist, which brings open Todoist right there. And you can create more shortcuts, by the way. You can create quick add tasks, all sorts of things using Todoist, Apple's shortcuts. Although this video isn't really about setting those up, but you can have a look at that, and there's some really amazing things that you can do with that. So there you go. That's using Todoist on the iPad. It's brilliant for capturing. You can capture email. You can actually bring notes from your notes app. You can capture websites, images. You can capture even events. Whatever you want to collect, you can collect it by just dragging and dropping using your iPad. And iPad is becoming a really, really powerful tool. So there you go. That's what I wanted to cover this week. I hope you found this useful. Don't forget, if you did find any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on the like button below. And it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done, so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.